speak student.
Circles, a la Shmoop.
Greetings, members of King Arya's court. I, Circumference, am the one who suggested our great round table. I know it's caused you all some issues in the past, but switching to a rectangular table would be a big mistake.
Ugh.
Let me tell you why, my dear chaps. First, a circle has no corners, so if we have to run suddenly off to battle, or to the loo, we won't hurt ourselves on the corners. While rectangles have two measurements, length and width, circles have a radius and a diameter. A circle's radius is the distance from its center to the outside, and its diameter is the distance from one side of the circle all the way to the opposite side, or simply put, two times its own radius. How much simpler could it be? Not yet convinced? Well, the best thing about round table is all the pie that comes with it. I don't mean apple or pumpkin pie, we can get those at the market. I mean pie. 3.14, the holy grail of numbers. The distance around the circle depends on its radius as well as pi. We simply plug in 2 times pi times the radius, and we get our circumference.
Ooh.
We can also substitute the 2 and the radius with the circle's diameter to get our circumference. But if we're trying to calculate the area of a circle, we'll need pi too. Pi times the radius squared will give us the area of our circle. In conclusion, pi makes the world go round. And if the world goes round, why shouldn't our table?